What's going on, guys? LCG here, back with Life is Strange, but this time I'm starting off before the storm. It is the 31st of August. This game just got released, and I am super stoked. I did a full binge of episode 5 of the original Life is Strange pretty much all day yesterday, and I played it through. I loved it. I love a lot of the material in this style game, and I'm really excited to kick this one off. So without further ado, let's go ahead and give episode 1, Awake, a kick in the pants. Let's go and see what this game has to offer. Now, I'm not exactly sure where they're going to drop us in, but I'm going to assume it's right before, or the childhood of both Max and Chloe growing up. Hold on, before we go any further with this, let's turn our audio settings down a little bit. Let's see how that is. Resume game. There she is, the punk rocker Chloe, smoking a cigarette, staring down a train barreling down the track at her. Chugga chugga, 1337, elite for all you gamers out there, super nerds. Really, Chloe? That's the best you can do with your life is piss off some poor train conductor?
I can't believe Firewalk is playing a show at the old mill. Fuck yes. Mom would kill me if she knew I was out here.
Oh, word? We're Chloe now? Oh, I wonder if we still have the ability. We can't rewind, right? No way. Alright, no trespassing. Private property.
No trespassing? No way.
You're such a rebel, Chloe.
Holy shit. This place is awesome.
Now that is a risky setup.
If I'm gonna get inside, I'll have to get through that door.
That's a real risky setup right there, to just come out to some old abandoned mill. So, what's up, bouncer?
Help you, miss?
You gotta let me in. Check it. I'm totally legit.
It's not a bad fake, kid, but you're in over your head here. Do yourself a favor and scram.
Fake IDs are a dime or a dozen. I remember when I went to Manhattan.
Should I go back and stand up to him? Or can something around here help me convince him?
Oh, well, that's a good question. Let's ponder.
Mom would totally flip her shit if she knew I hiked for an hour just to see a show.
So I remember when I went to New York City with my buddy, who was only 16 at the time.
This place is sketchy as hell. An old abandoned building in the middle of nowhere.
So we're walking on the street asking all the tattoo parlors if they would tattoo a 16-year-old.
Home.
And they were all of them obviously said no. And so one guy says, yeah, if you buy a fake ID too. So we essentially paid $50 for him to make us just the front side of a fake ID, so he could scan it, and then he's got his record that the kid provided an ID. And whoop.
Guess fire safety isn't exactly high on the agenda here.
Yeah, they just wanted to cover their own tail. And, Argument? Is that his name?
Those guys need to get a room. Or not. Damn.
Mind your own business.
This is where we go tell the bouncer.
If I owed somebody $1,000, I'd be shitting my pants.
Yeah, later on you will, Chloe. Yeah, so this guy made us a fake ID and pretty much let him get a tattoo at 16.
God, again? What do you want, kid?
Let me inside now? No. Let's just walk
Never
away.
Mind.
I was hoping I'd be able to report the two having a fight over here. Alright, let's take a look around. What do we got? Enough dilly-dallying.
Ah, perfect place for me to work.
Alright, let's tag it.
Now, what to draw?
Not a meth lab. That's a Breaking Bad
Definitely,
reference.
Absolutely not a meth lab. I'm sorry, officer. It says what on the side of my RV?
Oh, snap, son.
I'd join a motorcycle gang if I had any friends. That saw looks ancient. I wonder how long ago the mill actually closed.
So how do we get this bouncer away?
Guess it's been years since anyone's actually worked here.
This is part of the allure of this game, by the way. There's just so much to do and explore. I don't know what to say to this guy, though.
Again? What do you want, kid?
Is that your bike over there?
Yep.
It's, pretty cool.
Gee, thanks. Is that all?
Well... I have a feeling that we have to just let me inside now. Started a backtalk challenge. Space to continue.
I have to convince this doorstop that I'm not giving up until he lets me inside.
In backtalk, you use arguments and insults to get someone to do what you want.
Don't you remember what it's like to be a teenager? I just want to see the band.
I thought we went over this. Isn't it past your bedtime?
To succeed, pay attention to what your opponent says. Okay, so is it past your bedtime? Come on, man, do me a solid.
Come on, bro. Do me a solid, yo.
Stop being cute and just split.
Cute. Cute is relative. Okay.
Kittens riding tiny mopeds are cute. I'm more like Red Sonja riding a panzer tank.
Okay, kid. I get it. You're tough.
Okay, kid. I get it. What?
Maybe I am a kid. Because this place looks like a damn playground to me.
A girl like you? I can't protect you in there.
A girl like me?
You mean a girl who doesn't take shit from a walking pair of biceps like you? That kind of girl?
Oh, this is kind of weird. Look the other way.
Look the other way.
That was the wrong one.
Besides, people love me. I'm funny.
Around here? Funny people have a way of getting hurt.
You know, you can't.
Bam, I think we got it.
Without F you.
Being mean won't get you anywhere, kid.
Did I hurt your feelings? Are you going to go home now? And
this little mechanic is strange. I don't know. Sobbing? Apparently you have to be a sassy ass with
You're
Chloe.
You're not accepting no for an answer, are you?
Nope.
And you really think you can take me?
Yep.
What if I had a knife?
No problem.
A gun?
Don't care.
What if I had...
You could have a flamethrower, an army of robot ninjas, and a motherfucking dragon on a leash in there, and I'd still kick your ass.
I give up. You're all right, kid. Go on in.
A fucking dragon on a leash, baby. See, that's something I have to get used to. That's a timed... So, I don't know if you guys noticed, but in the middle there was a little timer that was going down. So, I had to watch that and make a decision in time.
Hey, Delia, come.
You dog.
Yeah, what's up, pup? Don't touch my soul with dirty hands. I gotta put my sterile mittens on. This doesn't look like much of a concert.
Can't wait to get in there and thrash.
Chill, girl. Whoop. Alright, let's go ahead and push through. This is what we came for.
Fuck.
Hey, you okay?
I'm fine.
Relax. You bumped into me, remember?
What a creep.
Fuck off, man.
Hey, you don't know who I am, do you?
No, and I give zero shits.
Hey, let me know how that works out for you, bitch.
Whoa.
All right. Mosh pit is a no-go. Fine. Maybe I can get a better view of the action from up above.
New dialogue unlocked.
Hey.
Frank!
Chloe?
I know your name, you idiot. You bought pot for me every month for a year. Look at that getup. Studs. You're trying too hard. What are you even doing here?
I'm trying to see this damn band. But this place is crazy packed. Hard to get to the stage.
How'd you even hear about this little shindig?
God, the internet. How else?
Seriously? Fucking kids.
Ooh. So, where do those stairs go?
Where do those stairs go?
Up?
I like Frank.
I mean, will I get a better view of the band up there?
How the fuck should I know? Floor above's rotted all to hell, okay? No one goes up there.
Fine.
Alright. Who was that guy
pissed off?
Did you
see that guy I ran into? Acted like I was supposed to know who the hell he was.
Yeah. I know him. He works for Damon.
Damon Merrick?
I see you've heard of him. This is his place. Damon's a friend of mine.
Okay, so you holding? I could definitely use something to take the edge off.
Of course. As soon as you give me the 175 bucks you owe me.
Shit. Do I really owe him that much? Unless I find some quick cash around here, I can kiss my high goodbye.
Let's skip the bar.
Suit yourself.
Yeah, we could do without the... Ooh, syringes. That's no bueno. Well, let's take
no
a
thanks.
Peek.
I try to avoid hepatitis when I can.
Good for you, Chloe. Do we want to try going upstairs? Sure do. This is how Chloe ends up getting hurt, I'm sure. Yeah, nobody goes up there, my nuts. Look at all these beer bottles.
Oh, yes! Finally made it! I can't believe it!
Chloe, you better take it easy, girl. Alright, so now we can go ahead and bogey out. I'm digging the music, but I'm sure there's more to this game than that.
You spilled my beer, bitch!
You should be more careful. It's a rough place.
I don't like your attitude.
All right. Look, man. I apologize.
Hey, I'm sorry about the beer, okay?
Not good enough.
Fine. Peace out, Cub Scout.
We're not done.
So now all I can do is talk
crap. Then how about I show you how unimpressed I am with limp dick assholes who get butthurt over a spilled beer?
I think she's calling us out, dude.
She's gonna regret every word. Every word.
Oh, this is gonna be good.
I'm gonna teach this little punk some manners.
I'm serious. You wanna see me get angry here? Because I'm getting there. And it won't be pretty. It won't.
She thinks she can take you?
Dickhead.
Choose carefully. This action will have consequences. So, we are already at a pretty volatile moment, right? We could probably take that broken bottle, but it looks like that girl is going to... Well, see, so here's the thing. If we run, that other girl's probably going to get jacked. So let's go ahead and attack. See what happens here.
Rachel?
Oh, Rachel Amber.
Come on!
Later, Gators! Yep.
Go, Frank.
Not gonna happen. Calm down.
Come on, man.
Walk away.
Screw this. Bullshit.
Get the fuck out of here.
Thank you much, Frank. See, we hated him so much earlier on. He's actually not that bad of a dude. The problem is, in an environment like this, you have to learn to either not take things so personally, or understand that you're probably going to get your ass kicked a lot. Yeah, and, I don't want to say that I speak from experience, but I know a lot of people that were involved in that 90s grunge punk rock scene, and it was not uncommon to see people show up to school or work just completely crushed, like their faces all bruised up and broken bones. Sorry about that, guys. I'm not sure what quite happened, but the game crashed. So after we escaped the party, here we are now waking up in what looks like Chloe's room. And I think this is the introduction. I mean, this is obviously where Chloe first met Rachel Amber. Or maybe not first met, but actually first started hanging out with her. Let's see if she's in the room with her. And Square Enix in Deck 9, as opposed to Don't Nod. We got some crushed cans on the floor. And this is This is at a point after William has died in that car accident, I'm pretty sure, but I don't know if Dave Madsen is now with Joyce or not. Is that a little bruise under your eye? A little fun fact, I don't know if Chloe was affected by this, but many of the voice actors for this game were not able to participate in the Before the Storm episode 1 due to a Voice Actors Guild consensus to not partake in any non-union work. So I know Max was affected. I forget her her actor's name. It was Hannah something or other. But Chloe still sounds like the original Chloe. So I don't think she was affected.
Sometimes all I want to do is shut my eyes and tell the world to go to hell. Daily rituals are important.
Max,
even
the
when
loser.
They involve writing unread letters to friends who have forgotten you.
Okay, go ahead and pause if you would like to. Oop. Let's go ahead and go back to page one. Pause if you would like to read this. And pause again. Look at that drawing. That's pretty righteous. Whoever did the artwork here is awesome. I think that's from, Mega Man? And pause again with Principale here. And page 4. And let's go ahead and move on. Look at this photo.
Hey, Dad. Another day in paradise. Right?
Chloe! Wakey-wakey, eggs and bacon!
Last night, seeing Firewalk live, those skeevy assholes, that girl. Was that really Rachel Amber? You smell like cigarettes and beer. Better change clothes.
Yeah, let's change those clothes. I'm curious as to what Rachel Amber's importance is.
I used to love skateboarding. It's the only mode of transportation that doubles as a middle finger to authority.
Oh, yes. Where are your clothes? In here? Maybe in this drawer?
As awesome as some of those shows with Elliot were, they were nothing compared to...
I saved all of these. You have to delete that photo of me dancing. Only you could get me to loosen up like that. Happy 2-month anniversary, Elliot. Ooh, she with someone. Fantasy poster. I'm not... Let's look at this photo.
Dad was so proud of me for winning that stupid science fair.
Yeah, because you used to be smart, Chloe. You used to be smart, now you just act dumb.
Man, I am killing it this year. Somehow I don't think Mom's going to feel the same way.
CDC, DC. Alright. Let's go ahead and try to leave here.
I should at least check out my dresser before I leave.
I tried. Where is it? We couldn't. Oh. Maybe I'm just a bozo and missed it. Butterfly. Bonus outfits. Word? Is this part of that classic Chloe? Do I have the deluxe version? I don't even know. I bought this a while back. Jane Doe, look at that! I think we like it. Let's rock it. 87.9 FM, the Seder, supported
should get going.
That little hip check she just gave the drawer. If I did that to mine...
Where's my phone?
Life would be
it's
mayhem.
Not here. How drunk was I last night?
Chloe, I said breakfast.
Guess I better try calling my phone with Mom's.
And guess who has
it? Okay. Mom's phone is probably in her room. I can use it to call mine, then figure out where the hell I left it. How can Mom look at this every day and not see what a tool she's dating?
Aha, so she is with Dave Madsen. She actually looks fairly civilized in these clothes. Not as punked out as, Ooh.
Sounds like my phone is definitely nearby.
There it is.
There we go. Wonder how many calls I've missed.
Wonder why it's next to the toilet. Maybe you should try cleaning up your mess when you're done. Alright. Will you be coming home at some point tonight? Chloe, will you be home by curfew? There will be consequences.
Chloe, breakfast! Bring my purse down with you, please.
Yeah, okay.
I think I saw Mom's purse in her room.
Alright, back and forth. Arcadia Bay. Yeah, that's not going to look like that too long. It's going to look like a tornado went through a trailer park by the time this tornado hits. Where would we have seen it?
It's weird that Mom's always hoarding these old catalogs. It's not like we have any money.
Listen, people like to window shop. Oh, there it is. Give me that purse.
Oh, can you grab my cell phone too?
Yes, Mom.
No more dawdling. I need to talk to you.
Yeah, that really makes me want to hurry.
Coming, Mom.
There you go, sweetheart. Showing that little bit of respect will take you a whole lot further than you realize.
Finally, you can put my purse on the dining table. Might still have time for breakfast if you hurry.
Dining table, here I come.
And all of this looks so familiar. I feel like we were literally just in this world. What, the purse?
Chloe, I don't have all day. Would you get over here already?
I should see what Mom wants before she strokes out.
That's not nice.
Hey, Mom. You wanted to talk?
Chloe, what happened to you?
It's no big deal. I walked into a door.
You seem to be walking into a lot of doors lately. When I send you a text message, Chloe, like last night, I need you to answer.
You can just say text. You don't have to say message.
And I need you to answer without the snark.
So this is something that, as a new parent, my wife and I have been talking about, in that, you know, if my child and I are fighting and they're out doing something they shouldn't or whatever, and I send a text, I would expect a text back, even if it's just to say, I'm fine. Right? Because at some point that level of concern starts to ramp up, and then, you know, the mind will begin to wander. And as much as, you know, you always trust your kid to make the right choices, or at least the best choice that you have equipped them for, it's not always simply about them. There are so many outside factors that can really they can really derail an already tense situation, right? So we'll just say, for instance, Chloe did get cut up last night. You would have no way of knowing. And at what point do you draw the line between, you know, my child has always been responsive and when they're never responsive? So, yeah. Sorry, I'll do better.
I hear you. I'll do better about replying.
Thank you.
Is that what you wanted to talk about?
What is it with you and David? Always cutting to the chase. Why can't we just have some pleasant conversation before school?
Two tough topics. Let's go ahead and talk about David.
You do realize I hate your boyfriend with every fiber of my being, right?
Chloe! You don't hate him.
He calls me girly. He's a dickhole.
He can be old-fashioned.
Yeah, an old-fashioned dickhole.
Oh, what's up, girly? I don't know. I think that's kind of cute and endearing.
Ah, right. School. My favorite.
You used to love to learn.
Yeah. I used to think drugs were lame, too.
I wish you wouldn't joke like that. Let's not fight. I made you breakfast.
Nah. I'll just grab something later.
Oh, you'll enjoy this. The other day I made 4 eggs, 2 for David, 2 for me. And just before I served them, he says, "What are you gonna eat?"
That's like when you go to the bar and order 4 beers, then ask anybody else if they want one.
What?
I know what time you came home last night. And don't think you can get out of school just because you missed the bus again.
Why would you assume that?
Who do you think your principal calls when you skip? Do you think I enjoy lying for you, saying you're sick just so you don't get expelled? Between your grades and your disregard for my rules, I see you slipping. I'm worried.
But Mom, the whole point of lowering expectations is so you won't be disappointed in me. Ever again.
You're happy doing what you're doing? Fine. Keep at it. Just let me know so I can stop fighting with Blackwell to keep you on scholarship. Money's tight enough as it is.
As those cupboards display, they could use a coat of paint. There you go, Chloe. There's something for you to do to help out.
Maybe David should start paying rent. He spends the night often enough.
How would you know? You're never here yourself.
Ooh, sassy pants.
David should mind his own business.
I think it's great David's taking an interest. He's a good man. Maybe he can help.
See, now, I don't like these decisions because you're either putting one down by comparison and bringing up a whole separate topic, or just flat out insulting the other. I think just saying David's an asshole, though, is the better route here, because dwelling on the past in a negative context is not a good way to remember somebody.
Your boyfriend's an asshole!
He's been good for me. Maybe he rubs you the wrong way because you've been rude.
He's still breathing. That means I've been more than fair.
Dang,
David's
son.
David's had some hard times too, you know. If he's kind enough to share his experience, I expect you to listen.
Like I'd let him get within 15 feet of me.
When he takes you to school today.
Very funny.
You will be nice, you will be respectful, and you will say thank you.
Are you serious? This is such...
What, Chloe? Such what?
Mom's trying, I guess. Maybe I should too. But what's the point in getting along if it means pretending everything's fine when it's not?
Ha ha ha. This is apparently another major choice. All right. Tough moment here, because saying what you feel is important, the problem is I don't think Chloe has the tact, and the wherewithal right now to do so respectfully or really understanding what she's trying to say. Being understanding can go in line with saying what you feel. But Chloe clearly has ants in her pants right now, so we're gonna just go ahead and say what you feel.
You want me to pretend I'm okay with David? That everything's okay? I'm not. He's a chauvinistic piece of shit, frankly,
Chloe,
and...
if your father could hear you.
No, you're right. I'm sure Dad and the mustache would get along great. It's a big bed. There's room enough for all three of you.
That's enough. All I'm asking for is a little respect. Why is that too much? I love you, Chloe. I miss you. Nobody could have replaced her father. I did the best I could.
Mom.
I don't know where I lost you.
You didn't lose me.
Right. David's waiting. He'll need the keys. They're in that ashtray you made me. Go be his problem now.
Bringing there you go, his Chloe. Keys is about the most humiliating thing Mom could ask me to do.
You literally just hurt your mom's feelings. How does that make you feel, Chloe? You need to take a step back, look in the mirror, and reevaluate some of your life decisions. Alright, everybody, this is LCG. I'm going to be signing out right here, right quick. Don't forget, hit that thumbs up button if you like this video. Be sure to subscribe if you'd like to see the rest of this series with my wonderful commentary. I'm going to go ahead and explore this room in the beginning of the next episode. And we will then take David his keys, right? I'm going to see what all this stuff is on the tables and see what's going on. Maybe we can figure out a little bit about, you know, I don't really care about the wine stain, but maybe we can water the plant or some other things.
I need that ashtray for all right? Mom's keys.
Yeah, once again, this is LCG. Stay happy, stay healthy. I am signing out.